When patching inside a rainbow and when using any of the export targets, parameters are one of the primary methods used to change the state of your patch. This can be both controlled in real time and captured in presets that can be included in your desired target. Taking time to set these up correctly will help you create a portable rainbow patch that will work across all export targets. In this video, we'll cover everything to do with parameters and presets and show you how to set these up correctly. The objects we use to control parameter state are param and param tilde. If you would like your parameter to update at signal rate, use param tilde. Snapshots and presets capture the current state of your rainbow parameters by default. If you would like to remove a parameter from the preset system, use the @preset0 attribute. We can set a parameter's name using the first argument. Being descriptive here is useful as it will help you when you or those you share the patch with understand the parameter function. This is important, especially when working with external targets. Use the second argument or the @value attribute to set the default value for the parameter. You can then set the @min and @max to set the parameter limits. If no min or max is set, the default range is 0 to 1. You can also add the @units attribute to define the units that this parameter will use. In some cases, it's useful to define whether a parameter is using milliseconds or hertz, and in this case, we're using decibels. Both signal and event param objects have some useful additional attributes that we'll discuss in a moment. The param object has inbuilt normalization and scaling that you can control in several ways. This is particularly useful for nonlinear scaling where sweeping the parameter across its limits, it should scale differently to its range, like a frequency cutoff, for instance. The right outlet of param and param tilde outputs the current normalized value of the parameter between 0 and 1. For this to work correctly, you must first set the parameters @min and @max attributes. Additionally, the @fromNormalized and the @toNormalized attributes can be used to exercise some control over the normalization. This is particularly useful for nonlinear scaling. These attributes are paired with the toNormalized and fromNormalized objects, which also have signal rate variations. To pair them with your parameters, use the parameter name as the argument. Here we have a frequency cutoff parameter with linear scaling. When the value is set to hertz, the inbuilt normalization tracks the value across the range linearly instead of logarithmically, like we would expect. Whenever we want to shape the parameter range into a normalized range that's not scaled, we can use the toNormalized attribute. Now the normalized value more closely matches the scaling. For example, to control the normalization of the frequency range from 20 to 20,000 Hz logarithmically, use the expression @toNormalized log 2 bracket value divided by 20 bracket divided by 10. Likewise, if you'd like to revert the normalized range back to its original parameter range, use the @fromNormalized attribute. For instance, to revert the logarithmic scaling above, use the following expression, @fromNormalized pow bracket 2 comma value times 10 bracket times 20. Now create a new fromNormalized object with the argument matching the name of the parameter you've applied the @fromNormalized attribute to. Enumerated parameters can be useful when creating parameter-based settings or modes. for your patch. For instance, if you'd like to create an oscillator waveform parameter, create a param object with the name waveform and use the enum attribute followed by the symbols you'd like to use for your enumerated parameter. In this case, we're using sine, saw, square, and noise. To set a default value, use the index number. Here we're defaulting to saw by setting an @value1 attribute. Now this can be connected to a selected tilde object, and the selected symbol name will open the appropriate inlet. You can encapsulate your parameters along with other patch logic and still access your parameters in several ways. If you need to set a parameter inside of a subpatch from within Rainbow, you can use the set object. Add the name of the parameter as the argument to the set object. Any value that you send to this object will be passed through to the corresponding parameter inside of the subpatcher that it's connected to. When you're using gen inside of Rainbow, this works the same way with the set object. We can access all of the parameters at the top level of our patcher by using messages formatted with the correct parameter paths. We can also use Adder UI to view the parameter paths and change them using the mouse. When you're using gen, you can access all of your gen parameters at the top level by using the @exposeParams attribute with the argument 1. This will allow the parent Rainbow object to access all of your gen parameters just like the rest of your Rainbow, Param, and Param tilde objects. Parameters inside of polyphonic patches can be accessed at the top level using the name of the subpatcher as the parameter path. You can also access any parameter for each voice individually at the top level of your Rainbow patch by adding an @exposeVoiceParams attribute with the argument 1. Each voice will become available through its own parameter path, which is indexed from 1 to the total number of voices. This can be useful when you want to control a parameter individually for each voice. Allowing parameters to be exposed to the top level of your patcher allows simplified control in all of the available export targets. For more details about parameters specific to each export target, see the relevant target video in this series and corresponding articles. Happy patching!